What's wrong with him?
He's fibrillating. We got a pulse in the house, but by the time we got
him
in the
guys,
truck.
Back up, please. Joseph!
Hello, Mrs. Krantz. You can't come in here.
Clear? Clear? You must say, Joseph, please.
Let the doctor do her job.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Life of the resident. Were you on that code blue?
Sometimes you feel so useless.
Oh God, that's good. That's the thing about residents, kiddo. You don't beat it, you survive it.
I'm just so tired.
You'll live.
Was brought across in 1228. Preyed on humans for their blood. Now he wants to be mortal again. To repay society for his sins. To emerge from his world of darkness. From his endless forever night.
There's no problem.
What do you mean, there's no problem?
I ask you what's going on, and you bite my head off like a rattlesnake.
Okay, okay, everything's fine.
What's it, a woman?
No, it's not a woman.
You constipated or something?
You know something? I think most murders are solved just by straight-out confessions.
That sounds like a cop that's lost his confidence. How many cases you got outstanding?
8.
That's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot. There's nothing to go on. I'm just staring at a pile of clues that don't connect. What am I supposed to do?
Hey, Knight! Gotta get down to the harbor right now, pronto. Nice tie, Captain. What, your kid naked?
Spontaneous human combustion. That's what this lady said. She was running around like a chicken with her head cut off, telling anybody who'd listen it was spontaneous human combustion.
I saw a TV show about it once.
Well, I called you guys. I was going to bag it, but I figured it...
You did the right thing.
You figure there was a person in there?
Were you kidding? You ever heard of a fire that destroys bones and saves polyester? Come on.
You will never defeat me.
If you leave now, I'll let you live.
Where's your glib tongue now, peasant? Prepare to die.
A wise man doesn't waste his words. Not in this lifetime.
Sir, are very skilled with your sword. Do you wish to have me through again?
And again. And again. If we have time. Well, shouldn't we pack for Gloucester?
No. We have all the time in the world. Time to write and perform. Live and love. We have been blessed with a gift. We can enjoy life. Forever.
Forever.
Suicide.
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you listening to me?
What?
I said we just got a call about a suicide. They want us to check it out at the hospital now.
Yeah, I'm coming.
You know, the problem with suicide is that nobody does it with any flair or panache. If I was gonna buy an e-ticket out of here, I'd do it in style.
Oh, yeah, and how's that?
First, a romantic gourmet dinner for two, followed by a couple of minutes of fabulous lovemaking. And then a nightcap of nitroglycerin. Talk about going out with a bang, huh?
When you found her, was the shower still running?
Yes, it was scalding by then.
And her wrists were slashed. I sent the one she used to the lab. This is one just like it.
How long had she been on duty?
20 or so hours.
Could have been a cop.
Was she upset or depressed?
She was tired. She just lost a patient, and that bothered her.
Well, that can't be unusual.
Well, no, it isn't. I've seen residents snap like this before. There are enormous pressures. It's the frustration that eats at you.
So you think she killed herself? Who's that?
Carl Jans, her fiancé. Med student over at the university. He was coming to pick her up.
Skank.
Come on, I'll take you home.
The incisions are fairly deep. Perfect, actually. She died very quickly.
Question is why?
Well, you're asking the wrong person. Only she really knows.
Maybe.
Okay. It seems a little strange to me, too. I mean, she was found with the scalpel in her hand. It must have been pretty hard to hold on to with those incisions. But not impossible. I told you it was quick.
So why does she do it at work?
Well, why not? She just lost a patient. She was exhausted, depressed. I'm playing the devil's advocate here, but there are no fast rules for suicide. It's a very strange, very personal thing.
The blood courses through me. So strong. So many memories.
What do you see?
A fight in the blazing sun. Castle. Moorish, I think.
The Crusades.
You were wounded. Nearly killed.
Yes.
I hate the thought of dying.
Then why do you think of dying yourself?
My blood told that to you. Have I infected you with that thought?
No. It's just that I don't understand, that's all. Not from you.
Life is so precious. And we are so blessed with our endless years. We must contribute to it, to add to it, to pay for those lives we've taken away. There will come a time when this lust I have for life will wane, when the plays I write will cease to amuse me, and when I will no longer shout for joy when I perform.
I can't believe that.
It's true. And when that happens, I will be a taker. Unworthy of life. Best to go away lest I become a burden.
That will never happen.
Yes, it will. And to you. And when that happens, we will do what we must do.
Are you going to investigate? Nick?
Yeah, I guess so. If I can fit it in.
Are you sure? I mean, I know you're swamped, and it probably was a suicide.
I'd rather find out for sure than settle on probably.
Okay.
Next time, try and give me a lead that goes somewhere. Ciao, babe.
Are you a burden, Nicholas?
nothing to go on. I'm just staring at a pile of clues that don't connect. What am I supposed to do?
Maybe it's time to move on, Nicholas. Maybe it's time to join me.
Why'd you do it?
I was already dead.
You had so much life.
I was a burden. I wasn't giving anything back. I was so alone. Isn't that how you feel? Please, Nicholas. I'm so alone. Join me.
What was she like?
She was cool. I mean, a lot of the doctors around here are very uncool, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when she first came here, she had this energy. Most of the residents start with it, but none of them keep it. It was like she was really here to help, you know?
She was always taking pictures.
Yeah, she liked pictures. Yeah. Her and the patients, or her and the other doctors.
Do you have any pictures that I could look at?
Yeah, absolutely.
Code 25, surgical ICU. Code 25.
Pretty amazing, huh? The girl was a ray of sunshine. You know, some of us think there's more going on.
Like?
Like maybe somebody killed her.
You still nosing around? Tracy, I think these people have enough to do without exposing them to hospital rumors.
Doctor, I've had many rumors lead me to facts. Anyway, she wouldn't have said anything had I not asked.
Then I stand corrected.
Is there anybody else who might have a little more insight?
Yeah, have you talked to Dean yet?
Oh, Sabina. What? That. The doctors sure are forgetful here, aren't they? We better keep an eye on them. It's time for lights out. But don't worry, I'll see you guys tomorrow night. Sorry, visiting hours are over.
I really enjoyed the show.
Thanks.
Just like to ask you a few questions.
Sure. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Yeah, I did a little time with the circus myself. You okay?
That's a loaded question to ask a terminally ill patient, Detective. Those shows take a lot out of you when you're on chemotherapy. This is about Marilyn.
Looks like you knew her pretty well.
I live here. Marilyn made it a point to know everyone very well. It was her talent.
What about her death?
I'd rather not talk about it.
I think it's pretty important.
You'll have to excuse me, but someone like me, with maybe 2 or 3 months more to live, has a difficult time discussing the suicide of someone I thought wanted to live as much as I did. She hasn't been much of an inspiration, if you know what I mean.
You just said you thought she'd like to live as much as you did.
Well, I guess old Dino was wrong on that one.
Maybe. Do you mind if I take the photographs with me?
Keep them and get out.
Thanks.
The boulevards, especially on nights when it rained. The lights reflecting like stars in the puddles beneath my feet. But it's so crowded now, so noisy.
Made me feel out of step with the time. Do you feel like that, Nicholas? Do you feel a part of this world?
You look awful.
Thanks. You wanted to see me.
Sit down, Nick. I've been considering handing over half your outstandings to Detective Cheevers.
You've been contemplating what?
Cheevers is on a hot streak. Maybe, just maybe, he'll find out something you can't.
I resent that, Captain. I mean, if you're not happy with the way I'm working out, why don't you just tell me?
You want to know what I'm not happy with? I'm not happy with this message from the administrator to Mercy Hospital, telling me that one of my detectives has been insinuating that the suicide the other night wasn't a suicide. And I want to know why.
I think it's a possibility.
Do you think she was murdered?
I don't have any evidence yet, but I'm not going to let it go.
Why? You got a suspect?
There's a patient in the cancer ward, and I think he had an unusual relationship with the victim.
Her fiancé says she was depressed. There's no prints. No signs of a struggle. The angle of the cuts were consistent.
Look, she had no good reason.
What the hell do you know about her?
Not enough.
Nick, the point is I cannot afford to care why she kills herself. Yes, it's a sad thing. But with a suicide, I already know who did it. Now get to work on your other cases.
Just give me another day.
Why is this so important to you?
I need it.
All right. 24 hours.
Thanks.
If you don't come up with something by then, case closed. Suicide.
Deal.
She finally did it. Took her long enough.
Why didn't she come to me?
She didn't want you to know. She grew tired of the world. She said that she didn't want to infect you with her disease.
I could have stopped her.
No. No. You're a fool to think that. Besides, she's dead now. Why do you waste your time? When there are those of us who want to live. Isn't it more exciting?
Take me to her place. Oh, no, this can't be hers.
If I'd known, I would have offered her my decorator.
What are you looking for? The young actress and playwright who loved to play men? The passionate tomboy with the fiery spirit? Well, she grew old. Nicolas, she couldn't keep up. What are you looking for? What do you hope to find?
Tragedy that we can't create life. That we can't leave children behind like my little Catherine here.
You're talking of death again.
I'm talking of death and birth, my love. Don't you see? When I die...
You don't have to die, Erica.
When I die, I will be old and tired. I'll have nothing to leave behind but my plays. Children, Nicholas, that is our sad, sweet irony. We can live until we grow tired of life, but then after, there's nothing. Mortals can revitalize their love of life and vitality with each new generation. Their children are their immortality.
What are you doing here?
We're friends of Erica's.
Yes, we go way back. Do you know where she is?
No.
I was hoping she'd be back. She has a new play that opens tomorrow night. She was really excited about it. Playing a little close, aren't you?
Seconds to spare.
So, we're feeling a little self-destructive.
Nick, will you talk to me? It's like you've been living in a shell.
All right. I lost an old friend the other day.
How old?
Oh, 200-300 years.
Old friend takes on a whole new meaning with you. Sorry.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
It was hers. Erica loved life more than anyone I've ever known.
How did she die?
You know, she had this theory. When you stop contributing to life, when you become a burden, it's time to move on.
Suicide is never the answer.
Isn't it? I mean, for us.
Will you stay away from the window, Nick? You're frightening me.
Maybe when someone's lived almost 800 years, they've lived enough. It's a crowded planet.
You're talking nonsense. You make contributions to life every day.
I sure haven't been doing much lately.
Oh, why? Because you're having a hard time solving some cases? Well, frustration is a part of life, Nick.
Well, then maybe it's time I die, Nat.
No! You don't want to die any more than Marilyn Siegel did.
You know something?
That's what I came over here to talk to you about. The other night, you got me thinking, so I went back in. I did a few more tests.
And?
She was 6 weeks pregnant, Nick. Marilyn Siegel was going to have a baby.
Hey, Knight, raise the drawbridge, and there better be food in there.
Stinky's here.
This is truly pathetic. Should we be talking about an alcohol problem here?
They were presents.
Presents?
Leftover from Christmas.
And my last birthday party.
Gifts?
Yeah.
Well, for your information, red wine is not supposed to be refrigerated.
Oh.
And I don't see how her being pregnant means she was murdered. It's a little dark in here.
I'll crack the blinds a little.
It just doesn't feel right, that's all. That a woman who knew she was carrying a child would kill herself.
Maybe she didn't know it.
She was a doctor.
Maybe she didn't want it.
Well, why wouldn't she have an abortion?
Maybe she's a pro-lifer, I don't know.
Marilyn Siegel was on a pro-choice action committee, I checked.
Don't you even have any crackers here? I mean, what am I doing here? Why am I wasting my lunchtime? For what reason? So we know that the woman was pregnant. What does that give us besides a growling stomach and major need of souvlaki?
Maybe a motive.
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jans. I'm Detective Skanky. I drove you home the other night.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember. What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Just routine. I had a couple questions I wanted to ask you, but I didn't want to ask you the other night because you were...
Yeah. I'm still a basket case. Come on in anyway. Hey, get off of there. Go on.
Marilyn's cat. Misses her.
It's a nice apartment. It's very,
It's very Marilyn.
Thank you. I was gonna say very feminine. You take these photographs?
No, mostly they were...
Marilyn, right?
Yeah.
She had a lot of friends, didn't she? Well, I think it's a good thing you're taking off work, though.
Well, I'm a med student between semesters. Look, can I get you anything, or...?
No, I just had lunch, thanks. Listen, I know we went over all this stuff in the car, but just for the record, how would you characterize Dr. Siegel's state of mind in the days leading up to her death?
Hindsight, detective. I mean, now, in my head, everything that she did or said was suicidal.
So in hindsight, you would say she was... I don't want to put words in your mouth.
Depressed, I guess. Tired. Very tired all the time. Distant. I guess distant.
Distant, I can understand that. You know, her co-workers at the hospital said she was the last person in the world who would kill herself.
I'm sorry. People at the hospital... Marilyn and I lived together almost 2 years. I loved her. I think I know a little better than people at the hospital.
Hey, I understand. I'm married. You don't have to tell me. So I guess losing the baby made it worse, huh?
We weren't even 100% certain that she was pregnant.
Oh, jeez. I guess I should have kept my mouth shut.
Oh. I mean, if I'd have known for sure she was, I would have brought it up myself. It explains a lot, really. I don't think she really wanted to have a baby.
Which brings us back to the abortion question.
And I just don't buy it. If she didn't want the baby, she wouldn't have had it.
What about this guy, Carl? How's he feel about the pregnancy?
I don't know. How'd you feel if you were in med school and your girlfriend told you about impending daddyhood? Uncomfortable, I think is how he felt.
Okay, the apartment, did it have plants?
Yeah, all over the place. How'd you know?
Maybe a pet?
A cat, hers.
The decoration, I mean, was it bright, cheerful, you know, cut flowers, stuff like that?
Yeah, were you perched on my shoulder or what?
Nick, that's not an argument against suicide. You can't tell from where a person lives what's going on up here.
Captain, I really think that she was murdered.
Okay. Who? Who?
Someone who didn't want her to have a baby, that's...
Someone who could use a scalpel.
There's still something missing, something I can't get a handle on.
Like a suspect.
I gotta go. Be back in a couple of hours.
Hey. Where are you going?
Let him go. I like him like this. Thinking again. On the case. Cop doing his job with some passion.
At least tell me where you're gonna be.
The theater.
What did he look like, Grandma?
Oh, he was tall, Catherine. He was so tall and handsome. His hair was like silk. But the color of straw, and eyes flashing with the confidence of a young man who believes he will never die. That's it. All night we'd dance. I was like a doll in his arms as he'd sweep me across the floor.
Oh, Grandma, can we dance faster?
Oh, no. You must wait until young men take you dancing. Wait until you feel that your feet have left the floor. Till you soar across the room, bursting with energy and passion. Thirsty to squeeze every moment you can out of life.
You make it sound so wonderful.
Oh, if I could only live it again.
You can stay.
No. It wouldn't be the same, Catherine. My dancing days are over, precious child. Look, the sun is rising to light your day. It will fill you with warmth and life. It is so long since it has warmed me.
Please don't leave me behind.
I must.
But there's so much to do.
I've done it.
Well, then teach me.
Just live it, Catherine. It is your turn now. You must live life to the fullest.
But I want you to be with me.
I will be. That, you see, is the miracle of life. I will live on through you.
Myra has cooked a fabulous pasta primavera. I'm about to crack open a playful bottle of Chianti.
Skanky, if you're in love with someone who knew that they're going to die, what's the best way to keep a part of them with you? Part of them alive.
Well, is this a trick question? Because you interrupted my story about the dinner that never was.
I think I'll wait for the movie.
You know, there's only one thing I like about working with you.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
Overtime.
Dr. Cole. Yeah, I realize it's late. Better go see Dean Simmons. He's a cancer patient.
Yes, I know, but I'm afraid you're not going to be able to get much out of him right now.
Why?
We just found him overdosed on morphine. They're working to save him now.
What is this, checkout time at Mercy Hospital? You know, this Dr. Cole, she's the same one that found Marilyn dead in the shower. How you doing? Good to see you.
Hi.
Did it ever occur to you that her finding this Dean guy is something more than a coincidence? Okay, it did. It occurred to you. Fine, I just thought I'd ask. I'm hungry. You'd think they'd at least keep a cafeteria open 24 hours just for the doctors.
So?
He's conscious. They're taking him back to his room.
How you doing, Dean?
Can't this wait till morning?
No, I'm sorry, I can't.
I see you brought some protection this time.
Detective Skanky. Dean, we don't think you've been entirely straight about your relationship with Marilyn.
Marilyn and I were close.
Mm-hmm. How close?
I don't see what that has to do with anything.
See, we think it was very close.
That's incredible. She was going to have his baby?
Yeah, sort of her way of making him immortal.
How was the theater?
Enlightening.
You didn't take Skanky with you?
Are you kidding? No, we met at the hospital.
Look, Skanky, what are you doing OT on this for?
Don't you ask Knight? He's my partner. He calls, I come.
What are you guys up to?
Well, I may be wrong about this, but I think we're setting a trap.
Detective, I know you're just doing your job.
Yes, I am. Something I gotta tell you about. No point dancing around it. We now believe your fiancé has been murdered. Can I come in? There's this guy at the hospital who has cancer. I don't know what type, but it's probably terminal. Anyway, last night we wouldn't have known, but out of the blue, the guy just snaps.
He killed her?
Well, we think he was in love with her, probably obsessed with her. He even said the baby was his.
That's crazy.
Well, you're a med student. You've heard of dozens of stories where patients fall for doctors. This guy just went over the edge.
Well, did you arrest him?
No, we planned to, but the guy got a hold of an overdose of morphine. That's when he spilled his proverbial guts.
An overdose?
Mm-hmm.
But he's not dead?
No, it wasn't enough. He's unconscious, but he'll pull out eventually. We'll get some more information then.
Let me give you a hand.
Think it'll fit me?
Oh, sure.
Here, take my arm.
Do you believe in life after death?
In a strange way, yeah.
I guess there's something in all of us that wants to live forever, huh?
Well, you're not going to get any argument from this guy.
Sky did. Yeah.
There, nurse.
Thanks.
All set?
Yeah. This where you're going
to be? Yeah. I should be able to hear what's going on through the wall. You shout, I'll come running.
Thanks, man.
Cheers.
Once you said you'd follow.
I don't know. I still find life exciting. And I think I've got more to give.
I always loved the romantic in you. But the time will come.
No. Not by my own hand.
Whose then? You don't really think you can become mortal? That's no more than a fantasy, Nicholas.
Well, I believe it. There are only two ways to escape eternity. One way is to join the dead. The other to join the living.
I'll be waiting.
So what'd you think about it?
It was great. I loved it. I mean, I know it was all about death, but I thought it was very life-affirming at the same time.
I don't know. I found it sleep-affirming. I hear the word play. Immediately, I think football. Call me a boor.
Boor.
It was a great play. Thank you very much.
Too bad the critics didn't think so.
The most insipid play I've ever seen in my entire life.
God, I didn't hear that one.
First review of Romeo and Juliet. Anyway, I hope this play has the same shelf life. Before Erica left, she asked me to give you this.
Thank you. It's beautiful. Did you know Erica very well?
We danced a few dances together.
She had an old soul, didn't she?
Not when I knew her.
Come on, Natalie. Come on, Nick. I'm so hungry I could eat the scenery. Wonderful performance, excellent play.
Good luck.
Thank you.
You gotta explain the plot to me. The wife is gonna ask me about it.
I noticed you dozed through most of the middle of it.
The snoring was a dead giveaway.
Did I miss something? What did I miss?
Only the Middle Ages.
Damn, were they funny?
I enjoyed them.